I just want to do a little bit of a comparison here. That right there was the top of the original first drop. That right there is the top of the step-up underfoot. Not even the original first drop. That's going to be pulled back all the way here. All this and more coming up next on PA and J Thrills. Get ready. Looking at the step up underflip now, it is quite amazing to see how much taller it's going to be from the original first drop. Like, that's probably about an increase of about 20 feet, I'd imagine. The original first drop was about 100 feet. This is probably around 120 feet. The first drop is going to be around 140 feet. So you imagine that drop of like the top of that element, the step up underfoot, but doubled. That's about where the drop is going to be. And that's going to be around an 80 degree angle, which is going to be amazing. Holy shit, guys. Just look at the top of that step up underfoot right there. Just amazing. Like, I originally thought, we haven't heard that many stats about Wildcat's revenge from Hershey Park. They've been kind of keeping this thing a little bit under wraps, all the stats and all, but you can kind of take it into account about how tall. I imagine that's around 120 feet right there, I'd imagine, because the top of that drop on Wildcat right there was around 100 feet. So I'm just taking a guess when I say those stats. Don't quote me on these things. But yeah, so just look at that. They haven't completed it yet. This is the part where we're starting to come out of the inversion. It looks like they're working on, and then we're gonna swoop down and use the original rest of the first drop for the rest of that first element. Very similar to Joker at Six Flags Discovery Kingdom in California. Doesn't look like there's been too much work on the first drop, but I think the focus these last couple weeks have been on the world's tallest step up underflip. It's just amazing. Alright guys, let's head into Hershey Park and see what we can see. Also, one more thing, that's all new wood right there. All this that they're reinforcing the original lift hill with is all new. This is why we saw all that wood a couple months ago in the storage lots, because you just see how much they had to... You can just see like where the gray wood meets kind of more like the light brownish colored wood. Yeah.
Chocolate Factory. Your guide will meet you at the entrance. See you inside.
We pour the blended cocoa beans into large revolving roasters, which get extremely hot. Toasty in here, isn't it? Next, we quickly cold the beans and feed them into our breaking chamber. Our pressing machine squeezed the unsweetened chocolate into discs of cocoa powder, known as Hershey's cocoa. Pressing also produces cocoa butter, which we'll use later on in the process. Make sure all of that milk meets our high-quality standards. Once it passes testing, we mix sugar into the milk using large batching tanks. We pasteurize and condense the sweetened milk and then blend in the perfect amount of unsweetened chocolate. This is where the art of chocolate making all comes together. As the mixture cooks, it begins to form delicious little pieces that we call chocolate crumb. Solidify the chocolate. All of that fresh, delicious Hershey's chocolate goodness is finally ready to be packaged. Everyone has a favorite. Mine are Hershey's Kisses
chocolate. Like Hershey's milk chocolate in special dog bars.
Hey, don't forget about Reese's peanut butter cups.
Aw, thanks, Alex. That's so sweet.
All right, so Candle Moon is currently closed. Sucks. But let's head over to the Kissing Tower. Alright guys, let's head over to Wildcat's Revenge and see what we can see. That just goes to show you guys how far you're going to be able to see Wildcat's Revenge. Like, usually you could just barely see it from Fahrenheit over here, but behind Fahrenheit you can pretty much see the entire Step-Up Underflip. That's how tall this thing is going to be. Look at all that right there. That is all new wood. Guys, look how much progress they've done this week. Kind of hard to see, but just look how much taller and steeper it is. That's what gets me. So hopefully in the next upcoming weeks we see the completion of this element. I imagine we see a little bit more before hopefully the holiday break. Yeah. And well guys, that's going to do it from today for Wildcat's Revenge here at Hershey Park. I hope you all enjoyed the episode. Lots to see. That element right there looks just incredible. It looks, I really like the Raven turn on Jersey Devil, and this looks very similar, except it's, like I said last week, it's a little bit more of a swooping down, whereas Jersey Devil is a little bit more vertical. But anyway, guys, that's gonna do it from the rest of this week. Before I go, I want to wish all my viewers a Merry Christmas and a Happy Holidays. Go spend time with the ones you love. And I will see you guys back, hopefully a little bit after Christmas, before the New Year holidays. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.